In this video, we'll learn to use crystal outline technique. And to begin, I'm going to select my browser tab, select some artwork to immediately create embroidery stitches. And to add the crystals technique, you'll of course need to be sure that you have crystals turned on in your techniques selection window. Now if I select a shape, and I can see that this shape is currently set for a step embroidery fill and it has no outline. And if I click here to add a dark blue outline, it will quickly add a running stitch outline. And in the outlines tab for properties, you can change to be crystals outline. And notice now that I've selected crystals for my outline, that it's placed crystals along the shape of the heart that I had selected. And the first thing you'll notice when you use the crystals technique is that in the properties box, we can control the parameters for those crystals, and it begins with the palette. And so if you know what kind of crystals you own, these are the choices. And so there are different shapes ones, or the Swarovski round. And then the second choice is going to be the size. And so right now it says this is can be anywhere from an SS5 with a size of, you know, tells you the exact size of the stone, up to SS48, which is a pretty big crystal and probably won't fit very many around my circle. But if you go to the little ones, then you'll see you can place quite a few along that circle. The next question is going to be the color of your crystal. And so you can choose to display them on your screen in any color that you want. Maybe let's try something blue. See? And select it again. Now you have the parameters for the offset, the item rotation, and the spacing. Well, first of all, item rotation, considering we're using a circular item, isn't going to really make any difference. But I guess if you were using shaped crystals, such as heart-shaped or teardrop-shaped, then maybe the item rotation would change the way the teardrop placed along that line. The offset, of course, is the way that you can move the crystals away from or inside of the shape. So if I add 2 millimeters to this, you'll see that the crystals will push to the outside of that heart. And a negative 2 millimeters would actually push the crystals to the inside of that heart. And you can control the spacing of the item. So in between the crystals, how much space do you want? It's by default at 1 millimeter, but I could change that to 2 and it would place more space between the crystals, therefore less of them. And if I made it 0, I would have more crystals and less of them. Now, notice when I did that, that little yellow X's appeared over those crystals. That tells me those crystals are overlapping. I'll change it back to 1. And I'm going to record a second video just to deal with the topic of overlapping crystals. So watch that video as well in conjunction with this one. So that is how you can offset your crystals from your shape and change the parameters for spacing and item rotation. Of course, anytime we're working with the crystal technique, that means we're going to use our digital cutting machine, and we're going to cut a template to use with the crystal technique. And so we have the ability to change the settings that get sent to the cutting machine. And of course, we can choose the cutter presets to tell it, first of all, if we're using what kind of machine we're using, and then what kind of material that we're going to use for our template. And then it will then select the appropriate, so crystal template material, smooth or flocked. And then it will change the cutter speed, cutter pressure, cutter passes, the blade depth, and the color of the blade that you use, since I selected the edge. Now, one more thing about working with crystals is the ability to separate to crystals. You see, right now, the crystals are a crystal outline. It's a shape that has a red fill and crystal outline. And the crystals are chose to be blue, and I could easily change them to be cobalt or whatever. And I could still change the offset back to zero, and I can still change the spacing to be more or less, okay? Once I separate the crystals, each individual crystal will become its own shape in the design, and I will no longer have those specific abilities to change the parameters. However, sometimes we want to be able to make fine-tune adjustments to the crystals, and that is why we have the choice for separate to crystals. And so now, instead of a heart shape outlined with crystals, we have the individual crystals, and notice they're all grouped together, so they remain like a shape. If you want to move or delete an individual crystal, then you need to right-click and choose ungroup. And now I could select just one crystal and move its location or delete it from the group. So that's my video on using the crystal outline technique.